This is uniform cost search, which is the second of our uninformed search algorithms. This is the map of Romania again, but this time the length of each road is also shown. We saw last time that breadth-first search finds this path from Arad to Bucharest through Făgăraș, which is only 3 steps, but the total length is 450, and there's actually an alternative path through Râmnicu-Vâlcea and Pitești, which is 4 steps, but is actually a little bit shorter at 418. So we want an algorithm that'll find us the shortest distance path rather than the fewest number of steps, and that's what uniform cost search is designed to do. The key idea with uniform cost search is that when we choose a node for expansion, we always choose the node whose path length from the start node is the shortest, which in this case is Zarind at 75. The next node is Timișoara at 118, followed by Sibiu at 140. The path length to Oradea is 75 plus 71, which is 146, making it the next node for expansion. Now, expanding Oradea theoretically should generate this path to Sibiu. However, we already knew a shorter way to get to Sibiu. So, in practice, we often use an enhanced version of uniform cost search known as Dijkstra's algorithm, where we store in memory all previously generated nodes, and we only replace a node if we find a shorter way of getting to that node than we previously knew about. I'm simulating this method by writing in brackets next to each node the total path length to get to that node, so the next node for expansion is Râmnicu-Vâlcea, followed by Lugoj, and Făgăraș. Now at this point we have found a path to the goal through Făgăraș, but the story doesn't quite end there because we don't know whether if we keep searching we might still find a shorter path. So instead we continue by expanding Mahardia and Pitești. This generates a new path to Bucharest, which is shorter than the previous one, so we replace it. But we still have to keep searching just in case there's an even shorter path through Craiova or Dobrita. It's only at this point, where the goal is actually scheduled for expansion, that we can finish the algorithm and truly say that this is the shortest possible path. So uniform cost search has the advantage that it's guaranteed to find the shortest possible path, but notice that in order to do so, it had to expand every single path which is shorter than the one to the goal. Now, in a two-dimensional map like this, that's not such a big concern, but if we were trying to solve Rubik's Cube and we start from a position that's 15 moves away from the goal state, using breadth-first search or uniform cost search, we would have to explore every single position which is 15 moves or less away from the start state, which is billions and billions of positions. So in the next module, we'll be looking at informed search methods, which don't explore equally in all directions, but instead target the search more in the direction of the goal. Another concern for both breadth-first search and uniform cost search is the amount of memory, because they have to store in memory all nodes closer than the goal state, which could be exponentially large. So the next algorithm we'll be looking at is depth-first search, which doesn't have to store all the nodes in memory, but actually only the nodes along the current search path and their children.